Type 1 diabetes occurs when the body's immune system mistakenly attacks and destroys the beta cells in the pancreas. Beta cells produce insulin, a hormone that regulates blood glucose or blood sugar levels. When beta cells are destroyed, your pancreas will not be able to make insulin or produce too little of it. Lack of insulin prevents the body from effectively utilizing glucose for energy. As a result, glucose accumulates in the bloodstream. This is a condition known as hyperglycemia. As time passes, high blood glucose can damage organs and tissues. This leads to serious health complications such as blindness, stroke, heart disease, kidney failure, and vascular disease. Type 1 diabetes can occur in both children and adults. There are three identifiable stages of type 1 diabetes. During stage 2, patients can still produce enough endogenous insulin to prevent high blood glucose. However, in stage 3, insulin therapy and glucose monitoring become essential for survival. The constant monitoring and need for insulin can be a significant lifelong burden for patients. In November 2022, Teplizumab, marketed as Sealed, was approved in the U.S. to delay the onset of stage 3 type 1 diabetes in adults and children 8 years and older with stage 2 of the disease. This medication is administered daily for 2 weeks via intravenous infusion. Teplizumab is a CD3-directed monoclonal antibody. It targets CD3 molecules on autoreactive CD8 T cells, deactivating and removing them from circulation. This reduces T cells' attacks on pancreatic beta cells. Teplizumab also increases the availability of regulatory T cells, which helps to moderate the immune response. These actions delay the decline in pancreatic beta cell function. Teplizumab's safety and efficacy were evaluated in a randomized, double-blind study of 76 patients with stage 2 type 1 diabetes. Participants were randomly given teplizumab or a placebo daily for 2 weeks via intravenous infusion. The primary goal was to measure the time for patients to progress to stage 3 type 1 diabetes. Teplizumab delayed the onset of stage 3 type 1 diabetes significantly. The median time was much longer in the teplizumab group, at about 50 months, as compared to 25 months in the placebo group. During the trial, only 43% of the teplizumab group developed stage 3 diabetes, compared to 72% of people in the control group. It is important to note that teplizumab is not a cure, but it offers a promising treatment option for at-risk patients. Delaying the onset of stage 3 type 1 diabetes can provide valuable symptom-free years, especially for children and adolescents. These additional years allow patients to be better prepared to handle the burden of living with a chronic disease and minimize exposure to high blood sugar levels responsible for various complications. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.